Let us rejoice and be glad and give glory to God. For the Lord our God, the Almighty, reigns. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of God our Father, his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon. As we gather to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us first pause and call to mind our sins and ask God for his forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Good Shepherd, leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty and merciful God, that we may in truth receive a share in the resurrection of Christ your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. A reading from Acts of the Apostles. The crowd in Philippi joined in the attack on Paul and Silas, and the magistrates had them stripped and ordered them to be beaten with rods. After inflicting many blows on them, they threw them into prison and instructed the jailer to guard them securely. When he received these instructions, he put them in the innermost cell and secured their feet to a stake. About midnight, while Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God as the prisoners listened, there was suddenly such a severe earthquake that the foundations of the jail shook. All the doors flew open and the chains of all were pulled loose. When the jailer woke up and saw the prison doors wide open, he drew his sword and was about to kill himself, thinking that the prisoners had escaped. But Paul shouted out in a loud voice, "Do no harm to yourself. We are all here." He asked for a light and rushed in, and trembling with fear, he fell down before Paul and Silas. Then he brought them out and said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" And they said, "Believe in the Lord Jesus, and you and your household will be saved." So they spoke the word of the Lord to him and to everyone in his house. He took them in at that hour of the night and bathed their wounds. Then he and all his family were baptized at once. He brought them up into his house and provided a meal, and with his household rejoiced at having come to faith in God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your right hand saves me, O Lord.
Your right hand.
I will give thanks to you, O Lord, with all my heart, for you have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels, I will sing your praises. I will worship at your holy temple and give thanks to your name.
Your right hand saves me.
Lord will complete what he has done for me. Your kindness, O Lord, endures forever. Forsake not the work of your hands. But because I told you this, grief has filled your hearts. In the past few days, our gospel, from John's gospel, Jesus is revealing the third person of the Holy Trinity. Jesus has been revealing the Holy Spirit, the Advocate, the Spirit of truth. And the disciples aren't quite getting it. They're not quite understanding that the Holy Spirit is God. But the Holy Spirit, God, is going to be with them, in them, with them, through them, in their very life. But grief has filled their heart because all they can think of is in human terms. Jesus, who they've been seeing and hearing and having meals with and walking with and talking with, is saying that I'm going. Their human senses only grasp that Jesus is not going to be with them. But Jesus is saying, but I tell you the truth, it is better for you than I go. For if I do not, the Advocate will not come to you, but if I go, I will send him to you. He's trying to give them the assurance that God is never abandoning them. God is never leaving their side, their life, their very being. They are beloved, just like you and I. In our first reading, we're hearing how, as the church is growing, that Paul and Silas are attacked. The magistrates in Philippi have them stripped and order them to be beaten with rods. And after being beaten many times, many blows on them, they're then thrown in prison. And literally, their feet, as we hear, are secured to a stake. You might think, well, at least they're in prison, they weren't being beaten. Now they can't even lay down. So imagine being tortured in such a way that you're forced to stand. But yet, during the night, we hear how they are praying and singing hymns to God. And the other prisoners are listening. And then suddenly there's this earthquake, the foundations of the jail are shaking, the doors fly open, and the chains that are holding all of them are loosed. The jailer wakes up and literally thinks, I might as well kill myself, because the leaders are going to have him killed for having lost the prisoners. And Paul yells out, do no harm to yourself. We are all here. They stayed. They didn't leave. But notice what the jailer asks for. Sirs, what must I do to be saved? I always find it amazing. There is story after story in the New Testament, in the early church, as the early Christians, the very first Catholics of the church, as they were persecuted, physically beaten, martyred, killed. People saw that and kept asking, how do I have this? They weren't asking for the persecution, but they saw joy. They saw a zeal and a faith in the people being martyred and persecuted that they literally, like the jailer, said, how can I have this? How can I be saved? Believe in the Lord Jesus. He took them into his home. He cared for them. He and his whole family were baptized. And notice at the very end we hear, with his whole household, they rejoiced at having come to faith in God. Do we rejoice in this gift of faith we have been given? Do we rejoice in the gift of the Holy Spirit that is with us, that God has never abandoned us? Do we rejoice in that? Do we share that like Paul and Silas, the disciples of the early church? Amen. Let us offer to our Heavenly Father our prayers of petition. For all the baptized, that we proclaim Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of our towns and cities, that they pay attention to the Christian message this Easter and receive it with joy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For nurses, doctors, first responders, that they continue to serve and heal in freedom of conscience. We especially pray for all those who are serving victims of the coronavirus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who cannot accept the Spirit of truth, that their hearts be converted. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this Eucharistic gathering, that we love Christ and sanctify him as Lord in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, your Holy Spirit speaks for us. Grant what our advocate inspires us to ask. In the name of the risen Christ, our Lord. Today's Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of Kathy Jill Fiddler. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for the cause of the Holy Church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, and all the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. Rose of Lima, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. The Christ had to suffer and rise from the dead, and so enter into his glory. Alleluia. Our prayer for an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. For communion, we are now doing it in a single communion line. So we'll start with this section. I just ask you to please remember the 6-foot social distance between individuals unless you're in the same household. And when I complete this side, then we'll do a communion line for this section. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers, that this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord with your life.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed day.
Thank you, Father.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil.
May God renew you in the humbly pray. And now, Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust in the hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world,
seeking the ruin of souls.
Amen.
Our
our prayer for the intercession of Saint Joseph during this time. To you, O blessed Joseph, do we come in our tribulation through that charity which bound you to the Immaculate Virgin, Mother of God, and through the paternal love with which you embraced the child Jesus, we humbly beg you graciously to regard the inheritance which Jesus Christ has purchased by his blood, and with your power and strength to aid us in our necessities. O most loving Father, ward off from us every contagion of error and corrupting influence. O our most mighty protector, be propitious to us, and from heaven assist us in our struggle with the power of darkness. And as once you rescued the child Jesus from deadly peril, so now protect God's children from the snares of the enemy and from all adversity. Shield too each one of us by your constant protection. Amen. For those who have joined us on this live stream Mass, thank you. We will return tomorrow for Mass at noon on live stream again. Have a blessed day.